In the next 20 minutes, I'm going to take you over the pre and post-processing of acoustic analysis in Astra and Nectron using an ANSA and Meta 22.01. So here are the different process. This is the process chart for setting up an Nectron solver deck in ANSA. The prerequisites for the user to create the solver deck is to create acoustic wrap mesh, field mesh, and directivity mesh. Once he has that, he can import that into ANSA and then update properties in Nectron solver deck. Once he updates the property, he also tries to update the material along with the properties. And the next step would be to create the domains and apply all the domains for the component that he has already created, followed by definition of the analysis type, which indeed has the type of analysis that he is interested in. He can select all the frequency domain, output, boundary conditions, and solvers. Then the last penultimate step is to create the topology. Once the topology is created, he can directly output the solver deck. This solver deck can be then solved in Nectron and can get the results. So now I proceed with a demo. Initially, like whenever you want to create a Nectron solver deck, if the user wants to create a file from Nectron, you have to select Nectron solver deck and then import all the three files, which is the acoustic wrap mesh, which contains three different mesh types. One is coupling surface, the second one is the air surface, solid mesh, and the third one is the shell mesh used for the infinite domain. You can visualize this here in this part. So the coupling surface connects the coupling the structure with the fluid, and the infinite domain is also seen here. The infinite domain is used to calculate the radiated power. Once this file is imported, then the next step would be import the other two files, which is directivity plot, which contains the microphone locations. The user has to keep offset and then include it as a separate include file. So and we need to switch on the nodes to see the microphones available. The third file would be importing the field mesh, which is used to visualize the results in the 3D. So once these are all set, the user has to switch now from Nectron to Nectron. This enables to convert all the Nectron files that are imported into Nectron format. After this, the user has to start updating the properties. The first one is the first one over here is the coupling surface. We give the name to it, and then followed by the solid one, solid mesh, which contains the air elements, fluid elements. So the Nectron, we need to create an Nectron component here, which is called solids, under solids, acoustic component. So once this acoustic component is created, the user has to change the name, give the appropriate name as air here, and also he needs to update the material. So we need to create a material, physical material for that. So in the material we give the consistent units here, 340,000, so meters per second. And the mm per second, sorry. And then accordingly, we need to give the density. So the user has to make sure that he is giving consistent units whenever he does the analysis. Once this is created, the user has to update this property, newly created property, to the elements that are there on the screen. Once you update this, apply, we can delete the old property, which is of no use from this point of view. Now, user has to update or create an acoustic component, infinite domain component. That can be created by changing the 2D mesh into infinite domain. That is available under elements, utilities, change type, 2D elements, and then you need to switch from 2D elements, from should be 2D and 2 should be infinite. And you need to select everything from the screen and apply. Once you create the infinite domain, you see an outward normal arrows on the surface, which is visible on the screen. After this, we need to update the infinite domain material again with the air that was created earlier. And then order has to be selected accordingly. Here we select 15. This is order to create the radial interpolation. And the P evaluation can be selected as 1. This is to evaluation of the radiator power through the finite and infinite elements. And you need to also create a coordinate system for this. You can put a question mark and say new, and then create a local coordinate system is CODR, which allows you to give the information here. So vector, you should to select vector type and give a center. For here, I select these values, and you need to select the coordinate system axis. Okay, we are aligning this to the global axis, so x should be 100, and y should be 010. Once you update this, the user should enable the definitions for these properties and material. So the user has to add the list or the column here as defined and select only the infinite and air, infinite domain and air. Other things we need not to output into the solver tag. These are the two components that are going to be outputted. The same thing should be done with the material. Only air has to be updated or selected, and every other thing can be left alone. So only these two properties and one material will be going into solver tag. Once this is done, the next step would be to create the domains. Okay. For creating domain, the user has to select the options, the auxiliaries, and then set. So once you start creating domain, the domains can be created in different ways. Here we are creating domains based on properties, elements, and nodes. So first we create based on property. We select air here, and then say okay, and we give the name as air. This is for the air component, and then we select again domain based on property and infinite domain as a property type. We give as an infinite domain as a name. So we maintain this consistent naming in order to have a link between the domains, components, and things like that. The next thing would be to create a coupling surface domain. So for that, we select properties and switch on only, show only the coupling surface. This could be created based on elements. So we select elements instead of property, and we select all the elements on the screen, and then we basically make the selections. Give the appropriate naming here as a coupling and surface. The next step would be to create two more domains, one for the microphone, other for the visualizations. For the microphones, we need visualization basically. So for a visualization, we go by elements again, select the elements, say okay, and give visual underscore map. This is for 3D results, visualizing the 3D results. The last one would be the microphone location. This is created based on nodes. So for this, we will go to includes and switch on. Before that, we will switch on the grids here, go to includes, and show only the directivity dot that, which shows you the microphone available. And then we select nodes here instead of elements, and then create the domain. We give the microphone as the name of the domain. So now all the five domains are created. The next step would be there's one more step we need to do before that. We need to update the things, update the topology. For doing that, you need to go to the, oh, sorry, you need to create a Loadcase manager, Loadcase setup. So Loadcase can be created from analysis Loadcase, analysis tools Loadcase. And then we create a frequency domain, select the frequency domain. So this is the solver. This is what we are solving for. So linear, and we give the values here as initial frequency, increment, and the number of steps. So 66.6667 and 1.667 as a step, and we take like 141 increments. Once frequency domain is clear, we need to make sure that we checkbox the entity, and then we now go ahead with creating boundary conditions. So boundary condition over here is BC mesh, and for this, like we need to provide the structural results that were solved prior to doing coming prior to creating the solver deck in Acron. So this is the solution 111 dot dat file for the structure where we have the responses or the results in accelerations. So the surface corresponding to this is the coupling surface. So we select the domain accordingly as a coupling surface. And once we select this, we need to provide a tolerance with which it identifies or it couples the structural results with the acoustic coupling acoustic elements. So here we provide the information like gap one from version 22 onwards. Like we are giving a pretty good description in the notes so that the user can visualize like the comments here, and then he can update the values accordingly. Once the tolerance is set up, we need to provide this solution result file, which is an Astron in this case, an Astron OP2, and the results are in acceleration. So we select acceleration. The other next step is to update the OP2 file. So you have to add it here under BC file and provide the appropriate OP2 file, which was solved earlier in Astron. We need to check this. And now the last step in this setting up is like creation of output results. For output results, we go to a new output FRF, and then give appropriate domain here as a microphone, because we are requesting the microphone results in the microphone, on the microphone. Again, we need to check box the entity selected. The last one is creation of the visualization map file, result file, so field save. We select a step here as 14 in order to limit our results file size. So we get for every 14 steps, we get the results. We take the results and we give the domain here. Again, we select the visualization map. And you need to give the name for it, results file names, or results underscore map. The extension here is .nff. We provide that information in this field and say okay. Before closing that, there is one more option we need to select, that is to select the solver. What is the solver we need to use? So here we use MUMS solver, and we change it to MUMS, and then leave everything by like default, like whatever available here. So after this, there is one more step. That step is to create the topology. So go to include file, and then put type here under column to select the type and topology type. Currently, the file is in Actron include file. So we need to create this, change it to or modify it to the Actron topology. So right click on it and modify Actron topology. Once this is done, we are ready to output the solver deck. So the last step would be outputting the solver deck. So now all the files that are imported were all set up for the Actron solver deck. And then now we will go ahead and output this file. That can be done from file, output, select the Actron as a deck. And here the best way is to select, create a folder, and we need to include all entities that are available. Answer comments should be none, and the miscellaneous you do output all includes in the same directory, so that all the include files and the EDAT file will be kept in one location. That is the purpose of giving doing the selection. So I have, once you have this, we need to run it in Actron. I have the results already done. So I'm importing the PLT file. This is the 2D results that were solved. The extension is PLT. We select that PLT file here. Exterior acoustic PLT. And that the domain here is infinite. We are selecting an infinite domain, and the radiated power we have calculated. So we say we change this. After this, we change the axis type from plane to DB, and give the appropriate parameters like 1e power minus 12, and the DB factor is 10, just to convert these pressure values or radiated power values in the native units to the DB values. We can also visualize the 3D responses, 3D results from the MetaPost window, and we need to select it from the geometry and select that file. Go to results, go to scalar, change the intensity to pressure, and the magnitude to generate 18. So the purpose of using 18 is that it will create 18 steps for each cycle of frequency. So every 20 degrees, it will create one image. So it will stack everything to give a good animation. And that's all from the demo.